was my state of, what potentially I would like my state of happiness to be 5 days from now, which could be 15, which could be 20. The point is that every event today at any instant of time has come based on a certain set of actions previously and will lead to a certain set of outcomes and actions subsequently. So here we are bringing in an element of a continuous series of events, what we call the universal law of cause and effect. Simple examples, process and scale. If you set up a process, it provides a high probability that the unit will scale up. Habits and health. If one has healthy habits, it's likely that there's going to be good health. Technology and efficiency. If one adopts technology, it is likely that it is going to result in better efficiency. Consumer understanding and pricing. It is very likely that if one has better understanding of consumers, one can price one products better. Risk and return, action and outcome. Like this, there are all events have come because there is a certain action which has contributed to that event happening today. If all of us out here are listening to the web conference, there is a certain action which has happened earlier and there is a certain action which is going to happen subsequently. So the point what I'm trying to say is that there you can define, if you can define one measure today, you can define a measure for that previously, and therefore you can define measure what you would like it to be. Modeling is nothing but, analytics and modeling is nothing but finding the path from where we are today to where we would like to be, which is illustrated in my next slide, in the current slide. So as we can see, the possibilities of no pattern existing are unlikely, or I would say it is not possible. And analytics is about finding the relationship from cause to effect, which I put in a small equation. Effect or outcome is a function of data, mathematics and common sense.